Hi.
Hi.
I just came round to see if you're going to go to those classes or not.
I don't really think it's worth it, Doreen. I'm only going to be here for 3 weeks.
Oh, that doesn't matter. You could go even if you're only going to be in here for a day.
You seem rather eager to get me in there.
Oh, it's up to you, of course, but they did go to the trouble of getting a teacher in.
Oh, come on. There's more to it than that.
Oh, well, it's just that David, Mr. Andrews, well, him and me, we're sort of, well, it's nothing really. It's just that I think he's pretty nice and I'd like to see him do well with his school.
Uh-huh. I see.
Well, he'd feel the same about me, I know. It's just that he's not allowed to, you know, being as good as a screw and all that.
Must be really hard for you. So near and yet so far.
Yeah. But that's why I've got to get somebody to go to the classes with me so that I'm not his only pupil, see?
Why?
Well, I got him into some trouble. And I feel real bad about it. I'd like to give him a present or something, you know, to make up for it.
Why don't you?
Well, I haven't got anything to give him.
My boyfriend's coming to visit me this afternoon. Maybe I could get something from him.
Oh, you couldn't get him to smuggle anything in.
Why not? Doreen, there are ways to get things past the screws. You must know that.
How are you going to do it?
Just you let me worry about that.
Hello, Vera. May I join you?
The staff room's for the use of all staff.
I'm getting some copies of the Modern Living course sent over sometime today. Special delivery. The department gets off its bum occasionally, doesn't it?
Your department or mine?
Look, I'm sorry about what happened with Doreen, Vera. I don't know what else to say. I mean, I could have kicked myself for letting it happen.
I don't doubt it.
My mistake was that I tried to treat them like a bunch of underprivileged kids. That's because I'm a teacher by profession, not a prison officer. If I'd had your experience and training, I would never have thought that way. Now, I probably did encourage Doreen to some extent, but it certainly wasn't intentional. With an 8 or 9-year-old, you can pay them the same sort of attention without having it being taken the wrong way. I'm just not used to relating to adults on either side of the fence.
You're not dealing with people who behave normally. It was a ridiculous mistake to make.
True.
You've got to assert your authority or they'll walk all over you.
Yes, I know. Look, all I'm asking is that please don't let what happened spoil the good working relationship that we had.
Well, I'm not one to hold a grudge.
Neither am I.
Hi.
No touching, Hamilton.
I'm sorry, Mr. Fletcher.
You getting on all right?
Oh, yes, yeah, fine. How's Granny?
Oh, she's fine. Mm? Looking forward to hearing from you.
Yeah.
You know, it's her birthday on the 4th, don't you?
The 4th?
Yeah.
Oh, yes, of course, the 4th. Tell Granny that I've met that prisoner, the one we saw on the telly.
Judy Bryant?
Yes, that one.
No talking about the other prisoners, Hamilton. Just keep it personal, OK?
Well, then I'm going to need a present.
What for?
Granny. It's her birthday, you know, I'll need a present.
Oh, right. Yeah. What should I get her?
I thought of perfume, and I thought of jewellery, but then she already has so many rings.
Well, how about a brooch or a pendant or something?
A brooch? Yes, that'd be terrific, wouldn't it? Oh, but I'm going to need to give you some money.
Oh, no, that's all right. You can pay me when you get out.
Oh, Gary, you are so sweet.
Hamilton.
Oh, no touching. Well, thanks. Granny is going to be very, very pleased.
Yeah. So tell me, how they've been treating you?
Oh, not bad. In fact, it's better than I thought it was going to be.
Yeah? Food's all right, isn't it?
Hey, Jude, you fancy giving me a spill in the press for a while?
What's up, love?
With me, nothing.
Oh, come on, you are not your usual chirpy self. Now, Auntie B listens to everyone's problems, even yours.
I don't know what's wrong. It's just everything seems to be getting on top of me lately.
You had a pretty rough trot in the outside, didn't you?
all started in the tunnel. Poor Irene getting killed. Seems everybody I get involved with drops dead. Irene, Sharon.
Sharon's death had nothing to do with you, and you know it. At least you gave that bastard Stuart something to think about.
Yeah. And I hope they give him hell at Pentridge.
What do you imagine would happen to Vera if she ended up on this side of the bars?
Yeah, there was Wally, too. Another victim of the Bryant touch. And Mickey.
You don't know about those two. They probably got off with a warning. Mickey didn't end up in here, did she?
Well, there's been nothing in the news.
Well, no news is good news, eh?
Yeah.
So why aren't you getting down the dumps about nothing? Come on, out with it.
You never worked as a prostitute, did you?
I thought that was the problem.
I used to know some of them in the gay bars, you know. I used to be treated like dirt by everybody in the place. It wasn't always their faults. I mean, yeah, some of them had habits to support, but some of them had little kids that they had to support because some bastard had run out on them. I always swore I'd never get that bad.
But you had a damn good reason too, Jude.
Did I?
Well, how else could you have got Jock Stewart?
I'll tell you what I was gonna do. I was gonna kill him. Then I end up working for him. Now, that's crazy.
Well, what you did was better. He's gonna have to live with that for a damn long time, and I wouldn't be in his shoes for anything. Now, isn't that worth turning yourself in for?
Turning myself in was easy. Just if it was worth it.
What do you mean?
Well, what do you think would happen to Vera if she was in here?
They'd probably stick her in isolation so we couldn't get at her.
Exactly. And don't you think they have isolation at Pentridge?
I'll leave him. He's trying to cheer poor old Jude up, that's all.
Mm. Hey, Doreen. It's best I could do in the time.
Oh, it's beautiful.
No, it's a cheap one, but it's a thought that counts.
Oh, I owe you for this, Sandy. I'm just going to the kitchen, Lizzie.
The door you just bend. Uh-huh. Oh, God, what's she up to now?
Oh, don't tell me that's this week's rosters.
No, some course of David Andrews. Hand-delivered by the department. Don't know why he bothered having them rushed in. They're going to be of no interest to our lot.
I don't think anything would.
Well, the sooner he realises that, the better. Well, if they're so important, he can collect them. Damned if I'm going to fetch and carry for him.
I'm going that way. I'll take them.
No, leave them there.
Look, like it or not, he's a fact of life here now. The best we can do is hope that he wakes up to himself as far as the women are concerned.
You've changed your tune, haven't you?
Well, we've got enough problems keeping the women in line without squabbling amongst ourselves.
David! David!
Doreen, what are you doing here?
Oh, I'm collecting the dirty laundry, but I just wanted to see you.
Well, you won't find any dirty linen here. You better get back before you're missed.
I will, but I wanted to see you.
Doreen, when I get these new classes on the go, I'll see you in the library during school period. Now, that's the only time. You understand that, don't you?
Yeah, I understand.
I hope so, because I mean it.
Well, I've got something for you.
What is it?
Here, take it.
Where'd you get this?
Don't you like it?
Well, yes, I do, but I can't take it.
Why not? No one will ever know.
Where'd you get this, Doreen?
A friend gave it to me.
Well, then take it back. I'm sorry, I appreciate the thought, but I can't accept it.
But I just wanted to give you something.
Doreen, I'm sorry, but I meant what I said.
Burns, what are you doing here?
Thanks for not being too hard on her, Vera. It was my fault. I took advice on letting her know where she stands.
I hope you told her in a way she'd understand.
Oh, I think so. My problem is that I don't want to upset the others by hurting Doreen. It's sort of a catch-22 situation. They could cut me off altogether.
There's a simple solution to that. Make the lessons compulsory. If you give them a choice, they can't handle it. Tell them they're going and they'll accept it.
True, but I'm going to need some cooperation if it's to be a success.
You'll never get it.
No, you're probably right, but it's my job to try.
Well, well, look who's back. Roll out the red carpet. Where the hell have you been?
Just needed an excuse to get out for a while.
Oh, yeah, and how is Mr. Andrews?
How did you know?
Didn't take much figuring out. What's Sandy Hamilton got to do with it?
Well, I wanted to give him something, a present, and she gave me a ring.
What? Let me see. That's a